Hello, friends. You're the Lonesome Gamer, and I'm still playing Where There Is Discord. And we are coming now to a point where we might see pretty soon a successful end of the mission. Probably not in this video, but I hope maybe in the next one. It's now the 24th. At the end of the 28th, we're gonna count the controlled areas on San Carlos, and then we're gonna look up the rules for the outcome of the mission. Right now we control 5 of the 10 landing areas, and there's still 3 units that haven't landed yet. The Argentines are out of supplies, which makes us definitely stronger now. Gives us an advantage when attacking. The main problem will be now the air attacks. Okay, we might see some submarine versus submarine combat here in the exclusion box. We got the Splendid and the Violent against the St. Louis. So, it's not easy to find a submarine in the exclusion box. There are deep waters. So, we can roll 2 dice, and we need a 1 to find it. And we didn't find it. And then it's the Argentines. For them, it's even harder. They have a 12-sided die. And they also didn't find us. Okay, and then let's do the search rolls, the detection rolls, to check if they find the fleet. So first for the submarine in the coastal box, and then for the patrol box, for the patrol group. And now the interesting point is this submarine here in the exclusion box. And that's only a D6. Okay, but it also didn't find it. And then we're gonna do another scramble roll. So we need an 8 or higher because the weather is gray. And by the way, there were some reinforcements here now. So we now had the Nordic ferry and the Baltic ferry, and we could place them here in San Carlos. Okay, let's see. Yes, fantastic. Another wonderful roll, a little bit lucky here, but yeah, that was awesome. Absolutely great. So no attacks this day. Very, very good. Okay, so now we're gonna see the San Carlos landing. So the last 3 units will now enter the islands. And here from the Queen Elizabeth II will come the Gurkhas, and because in Ajax Bay, and because there are already the Argentine units, this is in a post landing. So we place them underneath the Argentine forces. From the Nordic ferry we will see the Blues and Royals, also in a post landing on Blue Beach 1. And from the Baltic ferry, the 2, I don't know, paratroopers probably, also on a post landing now. The later the units come to the islands, the more likely they will have in a post-landing. Okay, and then we have the San Carlos deployment. There are only 3 units left now, so we're going to draw 2 of them and place them randomly. So the first one is number 4. So that is here, I guess, yeah. This is not so bad, actually. So we are at full strength here, and we're going to see a counterattack here. So I guess our chances are pretty good that we can hold that. And this is the 2nd Marines. So that is number 5. And this is now an Argentine... Oh, that's interesting. Okay, I gotta check what we do here. Okay, so... there will be no 2nd Argentine unit in that landing zone. So what happens is we have to place it in the nearest landing zone with a British unit, which would be then this one here. So the Argentines will try to attack Wreck Point instead, where the Scots guards are. We have both, we have here these naval gunfire support for us, so I think it's looking pretty good. We control the air space this time because there were no attacks from the Argentines, so that that day should be a good one for the British, I hope. And then there is only one Argentine unit left, so I think these are now quite desperate measures. Let's hope for the best. Okay, let's see. So that was the San Carlos deployment. And then we have here the San Carlos ground combat preparation. And we start here, following the numbers. So let's do this. This is a counterattack, which is good for us. And because there are no more supplies, this is flipped and they only have a strength of 4. Okay, do we see an asterisk somewhere? Doesn't seem so. No. We have naval gunfire, which is definitely good. That gives us an additional marker. Because here opposite is the AHMS Argonaut. And this is it then. So, let's see. The Argentines have a 4-sided dice. And I have a 6-sided dice. And that looks definitely good. Okay, we both have a 1. But because it's a counterattack, I win. So, I was lucky here. And I have a 3, they have a 2. And they have a 1, I have a 6. So this is a pretty desperate battle that they're fighting here. Maybe they should simply desert. I mean, it doesn't make a lot of sense here. Okay, and we got a 4, both of us. And it's again a draw, so... yeah, they died. and we didn't lose basically no casualties here. Pretty awesome. Okay, so let's go on. Then we're here, and this is going to be a little harder, I guess. The third parachuters are attacking the air brigade here. But on the other hand, no, it's the other way around. Exactly. This is also a counterattack. So this is going to be probably even more easy, because these parachutes are pretty good in fighting. They have an eight-sided dice and die. This is an elite unit, but anyway, they are reduced to a strength of 4 because there are no supplies left. So we have here the elite unit marker, and we also have naval gunfire support. So yeah, let's see here. Okay, that's the first marker that they lose. The first hits that they take. Okay, I mean, this is basically just slaughtering the poor guys. Okay, yeah, in this case, they got a 4, I got a 1, so I will lose my first marker here. K and 8. And that's a 5 against a 4. So they're dead. Okay, and this is now going to be a little more interesting here, definitely. We see the Gurkhas fighting the commandos. But this is going to be an opposed landing, which makes it a little more interesting. And it is also an elite unit of the Argentines. But they have the same problem. They have no more supplies. So this is an extremely important thing that you manage to reduce their supplies during the ongoing game, because then it's much, much easier in the end to do the fighting here on San Carlos. And yeah, sadly we don't have the naval fire, the naval gunfire support. But it's I think we have a good chance anyway. Okay. So the four-sided die is the Argentines. Okay, this is now this is a tie, and because it's an opposed landing, I actually take a hit. Okay, so that is their first hit, but it's only the marker because it's an elite unit. Yep, a 3 against a 1. So now they take their first real casualties. And that's a 3 against a 2. So it's actually always a little close now. I'm not rolling exactly great, but they don't either. So I'm lucky here. Yeah, that's what we want to see, an 8. So now it's basically, the fight is nearly over. Okay, so I will take another casualty here. But this time it's gone. It's a 6 against a 2. So they are killed, but I'm a little weakened. Not just a little, I'm quite weakened. So if this last unit should attack this area, I might have some problems to hold it. But anyway, at least I managed to conquer this area, which is a good thing. Okay, and then we'll see another fighting going on here. There's really a lot of fighting going on there. The 4th Infantry, they hold the beach, Blue Beach, and the Blues and Royals are trying to conquer it. And this is going to be a tough one. We're going to see an opposed landing here. The good thing is I've got a... it's going to be interesting. I got naval gunfire support because of the brilliant here. And this is an elite unit. But they're not that strong anyway. I mean, they only have a 6. But they have these two additional markers, which is definitely an advantage. And the others, because they have no supplies, only have a 4. So I think the odds are definitely on our side. Let's see. Yep. That's a first hit here. Okay. This is looking good. Very good start. Yeah, that's a 3 against a 2. It's also great. So, only one more hit, and everything is fine. That wasn't good, so we will lose a marker here. But we have two markers before we lose any life points. So, okay, that's a tie, and because it's an opposed landing, we will lose another marker. That's a 3, that's a 2. Shit. So these are our first real casualties now. Yeah, and this is it, a 3 against a 1. So we managed to win this battle here with little casualties. Blue Beach 1. And then finally, we got here another opposed landing. On Blue Beach 2. There's the 3rd Marines. They are also reduced. Because this is not a warship, it's just a landing ship, I don't get the gunfire support marker. But I got a 8-sided die against a 4-sided die. So I guess it's looking good. Damn, I missed something here. Yeah, there is this dug-in marker where we have an opposed landing. I missed that. Okay, so that is actually important. I think I missed that somewhere before too. Yeah, I guess we've seen that here and here. So I try to correct that now. The Argentines have an additional marker here actually, if there is an opposed landing. So there was this one here. And I will roll an 8-sided die against a 4-sided die where the Gurkhas attacked the Argentines. Okay, but that is an 8 against a 4, so that would have been the extra life point. And then we see the same thing here. where the Blues and Royals attacked. And they have only a six-sided die against a four-sided die. Okay, so that would have been another hit against them. Then let's see. Oh gosh, okay. So the outcome here is now pretty open. It's not easy. Okay, that was close. A three against a six. But we managed to finally kill them. But we took heavy casualties here. Okay, so I must remember that we have this duck in marker here when we have an opposed landing. Which is also now the case. So we're going to place that here. And then we have an eight-sided die against a four-sided die. Yeah, that's definitely a hit. Seven against a three or what it was. Oops. Okay, an eight against a three. Yep. Seven, very good. Six, that's definitely enough. So this is a pretty clear victory, I think. And a three against a three. Well, that would not be enough because of the opposed landing. So we take a hit here. And that's again a three against a three. Damn. So we take another hit. Oh, damn it, a three against a four. Man, this sucks. I want to win that battle. Come on. Oh, shit, you're kidding. A two against a two. So I've lost that battle. Unbelievable. Oh, man, that sucked. So they were able to hold this beach. Very, very close. Extremely unlucky here. But okay, and this is basically now the outcome of the battle, I guess. Not completely, because we might see another attack here, or we will see another attack here, and we might see some more attacks from the air. But overall, we now control seven areas, and we were really unlucky here. I guess we could have easily controlled eight, but okay, I mean, damn. Okay, so it's 26th of May. The weather is misty, so we have a plus one scramble modifier. So on an eight or higher, we won't see an attack. No, that's actually not true. On a seven or higher, we won't see an attack. So there is a good chance that we won't see one. Let's see. Okay, this time we're not that lucky, so we will see an attack. So we're gonna see four Skyhawks. These are two here. Four Skyhawks attacking San Carlos. We got these two Harriers here. And they're gonna try to stop these guys with these Sidewinders. So let's hope for the best. We need a six that would destroy two of them, or a two and a three. Oops. That wasn't great. At least a two. But that wasn't exactly a great roll. Okay, we destroyed one Skyhawk. That's a start. They cannot shoot back because they only have air-to-surface capability. Okay, then let's see where the remaining three aircraft will attack. That's a one and a ten And another one. Okay. So let's see. If that box is empty, place it in the nearest occupiers box. So we will see here two attacking the broadsword and one attacking the Andromeda. Okay. Then we can roll a d6 now, because it's a... Yeah, it's the fifth day of Operation Sutton, so we can roll a d6 now for every aircraft, and on a 1 we managed to destroy it. So let's start with the 2 that attack the broadsword. Ah, damn it. No success here. And then the other one. No. Okay, it sucks. And then we're gonna attack the aircraft. And let's see. I think we should concentrate on that ship here, the broadsword. So let's see. Let's say with 2 T-22 and 1 LDR, we're gonna try to attack these 2 Skyhawks here. So we can roll a D4 for the 220 T-22. Let's see. Oh, come on, no success here. And a D6 for the LDR. No, we're rolling pretty bad now. So we didn't manage to destroy anything here. And now the Andromeda is defending herself, also with a 6-sided die. Oh gosh. Now they will attack, and they have a D6. And let's see, the Skyhawk that attacked the broadsword. Okay, we were lucky here too. So no success here, and the other one. Okay, that was close, but also no success. So overall, nothing did happen. And that was the first attack. Let's roll another scramble. Do another scramble roll. Definitely an attack. Okay, now we're seeing 4 Mirage attacking here, the Southwest, the Sheffield, the Bristol, and the Antelope. But these are no bad vessels. So, the T-42, yeah, we have a radar number of 6. So at 30 miles, we won't roll. We will let them come closer. So, yeah, they're now at 20 miles. And we start rolling here. Okay, so that is already, let's see, 20 miles. Is that interesting? Yeah. I mean, we could try it with 20 miles. It's a D6. It's not that bad. The Sheffield and the Bristol, they could both attack with a 6-sided die. Okay, I think we should do that from a 20 miles distance. So we have 4 6-sided dies to do the target lock roll. And we see a 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. Okay, so now we're gonna roll with 2 dice. The Sheffield and the Bristol will fire. And the outer range of this missile system of the Antelope. So let's see. Well, that's a 5. It's not exactly great. A 5. So we managed to destroy 1 Mirage. Could have been better. Yeah, not great. And, well, let's see, they come closer now. They're at 10 miles. And the antelope can still try to shoot, but we didn't get a radar log here. So now they are at 1 mile. Yeah, that's a radar log, so the antelope will get a chance to shoot here with a D6. So let's do the radar log first. That's a 4. Well, actually, we have to roll for every plane. So the first one has a 4. The next one has also a 4, and the last one has a 3. So it would be awesome now if we could roll. If we could roll a 4, that would be just great. So the antelope shoots now with a D6. Ah, damn it, that's a 6. So no hit here. So this is dangerous. We will see now an attack from 3 Mirage onto these ships. And the Mirage have a D10, which is. Okay. We'll see. Okay, the Sheffield is the first target. We could do it randomly, but it doesn't matter. Every Mirage will attack one vessel. So the Sheffield is the first target here. No hit. Then the Bristol. No hit. And finally, the Antelope. And that was close, but also no hit. Lucky here. Okay, let's see if we will see a third sortie. Yes, definitely. Okay, we're gonna see two daggers which attack from the north, where there is the Antrim and the Hermes. Good thing is the Nimrod could detect this attack, so we could scramble these two harriers here, and we're gonna see some air-to-air combat this time. Okay, we have a target lock of 2 and 5 with an 8-sided die, and we missed. And now they can actually shoot back. They can. Yeah, and they use the 12-sided dice. And that's a 2 and a 7. And let's remember that simply, a 2 and a 7. And then they shoot. Wait a second, I forgot. I forgot, I got my sidewinders. So that means I can roll again with 2 dice. Because I can roll 4 dice. I can roll 2 dice for each one. So I can roll again. Maybe I do a hit. I had a 2 and a 5. Yeah, that's great. So I destroyed one of these suckers. Very good. Very good. Okay, and then yeah, let's see. So let's do again this target lock roll for the remaining dagger. So we got an 11 and a 2. Okay. And then we simply roll. Oh gosh, that's an 11. So we've lost one of our harriers here. Well, there are not too many left now, but it's still okay, I guess. Okay, so the Hermes has a radar number of 5. So now they are at a 30-mile distance. And I'm not gonna attack at that distance. So now they are 20 mile, and let's see, we got a 2, that's a lock. So let's see, 20 miles. Well, actually I cannot, it's out of range for me. What about the CTY? Well, they could try it here. I think I still let them come closer. So they are now at 10 miles. Ah. So now it's at 1 mile. Ah, damn it. No more radar locks. So that was a... Okay, I didn't manage to... I cannot attack them. So the dagger will now try to shoot us. And we'll use a D10. So on a 1 or 2 5, it's the Antrim. On a 6 to 10, it's the Hermes. Yeah, the Hermes is the target, so I definitely don't want to lose that. Would be pretty terrible. So, yeah, we got a dagger. Okay, that's a 2. That was close, but in the end, nothing happened. Luckily, only one aircraft was remaining. Okay, so that was the third attack. Let's see if we'll see a fourth one. Yes, we will. Okay, so we see now three daggers attacking San Carlos waters. Let's do the small arms fire. First two attack the ones that attack here, the Argonaut. Yeah, that's a hit. Very good. So one dagger was destroyed by the British ground units. And then this one here. No. Okay, but that's at least something. Okay, and then let's see. Each warship can now attack. So, the broadsword and the Argonaut will attack this dagger here. And, so that is a D6 for the LDR, for the Argonaut, and a D4 for the broadsword. So, hey, maybe we're lucky. Ah, not quite. So we couldn't destroy it, and same situation, yeah, same situation here. Yes! Great! So the Andromeda destroyed actually the dagger. That was pretty awesome. So there is now only this attack here on the Argonaut. And well, we simply roll a D8. Let's see what happens. And nothing happens. Very good. Very, very good. Okay, so finally, let's see if we will see a last attack this turn or not. Yes, we will. Okay, and we see three daggers again attacking up here, the Arrow and the Coventry. We didn't attack the attack, so we cannot scramble any Harriers. So let's do a radar lock, and I think the radar lock number was 6 here. Okay, so I will not roll for 30 miles. I risk it. Let them come closer to 20 miles. And that is a successful radar lock. So I'm going to try it here. And let me see. We got a 42 and the T21. So they're out of range of the Arrow, but the Coventry can actually fire. They can use a D6. So let's see. So we got twice a 4 and a 1. So a 4 would be a fantastic result now if we shoot. Come on, Coventry. Roll a 4. That's a 1, but that's okay. I mean, it's not so bad. So we managed to destroy 1. dagger. And they are in a 20-mile range. So now they come closer to 10 miles. And we got to roll our target lock again. And nope. So it's now 1 mile. Yes, that was good. So they are at 1 mile. And this is the perfect range for the arrow. So maybe we're lucky here. So it's again a D6. So two daggers are left. That's a 6 and a 2. Here we are. 6 and 2. Let's see. Maybe the arrow hits. Yeah, fantastic. Very good. So another dagger was destroyed. Great. So there's only one left. Let's see which vessel is the target. 1, 2, 3 is the arrow. Otherwise, it's the Coventry. It is the Coventry. And the dagger will roll a D10. Okay, so let's hope for the best here. Whoa, close again, but no hit. Very, very good. So yeah, I mean, it's looking really good. That's the end of the day. We survived all 5 attacks without any casualties. And 2 days remaining. Until now, we were quite lucky. We didn't see any exocets attack in the last days. It's amazing. On the other hand, only a 2 or a 3 would be an exocet attack. So, yeah, only in 20%. But we were definitely lucky. We didn't roll these. Lots of daggers. Okay. Anyway, so, yeah, I think it's time now to stop this. And guess we're gonna do 1, maybe 2 videos, depends on how many attacks we're gonna see then in the next videos. Hope to see you then. Bye.